Hello dear students, hope you'll be fine. So enjoying your holiday? Right? Not much. Fine. You should not. You should enjoy, but at the same time you should make maximum utilization of the time that you are getting. It's a very precious time. Right? So in the previous lecture I discussed about the dipole and the relation to determine the electric field at a point on the axial point of a given dipole, right? So today I'll explain one or two numericals and then I'll carry on with the further derivation part, right? So let's proceed. As I have been saying so, like quite frequently I've been saying so. So the thing is, I'll be reading out the question. You just take hold of that question and I'll be writing the important part and then I shall be solving the question for you. Right? So let us see first. The question is, two similar ball, each having mass m and charge q, are hung from a fixed point by a silk thread of length l. Now, first, let us make use of the till now statement. So, there are two balls. Fine. There are two balls. Why I have separated? I'll explain that to you. L and L. Both the masses M. Fine. Both are having a charge, equal charge, so Q. So, just take an example. We have two charges. These two markers represent two charges, right? And both the charges are equal in nature. So what would happen? They would be experience a force, and that force will be what? A force of repulsion. So in this case also, they are experiencing a force of repulsion, as a result of which they are being separated, right? Now is it clear that why I have drawn such way? Now, then let us take a point. Now, see, they are both must be separated by some distance, let it be r or something else, whatever it is. Now we will proceed for the other part of the question. The length is L, fine, that is given, I have written that. And prove that the equilibrium separation x is given by, so instead of r, we will say x, the both the charges are being separated by a distance x, and we have to prove that x is given by q square l divided by 2 pi epsilon naught mg whole power 1 by 3. Okay, fine? Okay. And it is also given that each thread makes a small angle. Okay, that is to be taken note of, a small angle theta with the vertical. So this is the vertical and it is making an angle theta. So this would also make an angle theta. Fine. Now, whenever we suspend a ball or anything, any mass to a thread, to a rigid support, the ball will try to pull it towards the earth. Right? Rightly so. And just take an example of a pendulum. If it has been made to move up it from its restoring point, that is the fixed point, it will exert a force, and to complement that, a tension will be applied along the thread line. Fine? So this is the resultant force. Fine? Ab humne kya karna hai yahan pe? Iske rectangular component mein isko break karna. So we are having an angle theta over here. So we will make an angle theta at this point. Now, since this is theta, so this axis would be perpendicular. So parallel to this, we have T sine theta working opposite to this thing. Fine? So we have two components. One is T sine theta and one is what? So T sine theta is acting along this direction. So T sine theta, and then this is base component, So T cos theta is working in the upward direction. So we have resolved tension into two of its rectangular component. One is T cos theta and another one is T sin theta. Hope this must be clear to you all. Now, since both the masses are having same charges, they would be exerting a force of repulsion between them. So let us say a Coulomb's law, a Coulomb's force is then exerted on mass number 2 by the mass number 1. Same thing. So now we are in state to equate the forces. Right? So now let's proceed the solving part. Right? First of all, T sin theta. T sin theta is equating which one? The force, electrostatic force. So that would be what? K, Q and Q2, since both the charges are same. So KQ square upon R square, that is distance. So distance in this case is equal to X square. I think this must be very much clear to you all. And second part, that is T cos theta, it is equal to, T cos theta is equal to what? The weight of the body. So the weight of the body is what? Mg. So equated with Mg. This is equation number 2. Now, what we will do is that we will divide equation number 1 by equation number 2. So T sin theta divided by T cos theta should be equal to KQ square upon X square Mg. So T got cancelled. So now we have tan theta is equal to KQ square upon X square into Mg. Now we have this as equation number 3rd, right? Now let us see what they demand. We need to find X. X is here. Mg component is here. K, okay, fine. We will do with that. टू अगर हम ऊपर नीचे मल्टीप्लाई कर देते तो 2 एप्सिलॉन नॉट होता है यहां पे कि हमारा है तो जाते हैं क्यू भी है ना वी आर मिसिंग द टू थिंग्स ठीक है वन थिंग एक्चुअली एल एल नहीं है और एक और दूसरी बात यहां पे है कि यहां पे tan थीटा मुझे नहीं चाहिए ठीक है तो tan थीटा को हटाना है मुझे और एल को लाना है तो क्या करेंगे हम यहां पे सिंस सी सिंस एंगल इज स्मॉल ठीक है इन द वेरी लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ द स्टेटमेंट ऑफ द क्वेश्चन I said that it is making a very small angle. So in that case, tan theta should be almost equivalent to theta. And since it is equal to theta, so theta is equal to L of R. So L is what? Length of the R. And R is the radius. So L kya hai yahan pe? X by 2. Theek hai? Half of the bar. X by 2. So let it be X by 2 divided by, that is L. Theek hai? So theta is equal to this much. So, वो tan theta के बराबर है हमारा ठीक है तो अब ये इक्वेशन नंबर हमने क्या ले लिया 4 अब इन दो इक्वेशन को हम आपस में कोरिलेट कर देंगे सो नाउ वी हैव x डिवाइडेड बाय 2l इज इक्वल टू k q स्क्वायर अपॉन x स्क्वायर इनटू mg राइट सो x क्यूब इज इक्वल टू q स्क्वायर इनटू 2 into L divided by 4 pi epsilon naught into mg. You just solve it out. So x is equal to q square L divided by 2 pi epsilon naught mg. So we got the relation. So what is crux? When you take down the question, always try to draw a rough point, rough sketches, so that you could know what question is saying and what you are thinking about that question. You cannot be out of context, so do think it properly. Fine? So let's take a hold of this, and the next part of the same thing, I shall be doing some theory part, that is the dipole one, and this is clear. Okay, fine. See. So, I'll discuss in the previous lecture, I have already discussed about electric field to determine electric field at a point. Which point? First, axial point. Fine. We did it. We already have completed this thing. Second, equatorial. We haven't. So today we will discuss about determining the electric field due to a dipole at a point which is equidistant from both the charges, that is equatorial point. Fine. So let us first draw the points, diagram. So minus Q plus Q, it is a set of dipole. It has been separated by, let's say, distance 2a. So halfway path is a, another a, and there is a point P. There is a point P which is equidistant from both the charges. Let it be R. And from the center, it is positioned at a distance x. This must be very much clear to you all. Now, since it is negative charge, the electric field should be acting towards it instead of going out. Now you see, first I drew that, and then for your convenience, for your better understanding, I just rubbed it out and pointed that field line towards minus Q. So agar hum log isko A aur isko B consider kar le, so it would be E A. And since this is positive charge, it should be E B. Fine. Now, the position vector is making an angle theta with the line joining the charges of the dipole. Fine. Now we know that dipole will be acting always in the direction from negative to positive. So if we need to give the direction for the dipole, it will be like this: minus to positive. Okay. As I have repeated again and again. Fine. Now we have components. We will resolve it the components. So EB. Okay. So EB. This is angle theta. So this is angle theta. So this is EB sine theta. And here it is EB cos theta. Is it clear? Fine. Now same about EA. So we have EA cos theta, and then we have what? We have E A sin theta. Now take a close look. E B sin theta and E A sin theta both are acting opposite each other, and they would only cancel each other if the magnitude of E A and E B are both equal. As we can say that, we can see that the distance between both the of the point from both the charges is equal. So magnitude wise EA should be equal to EB, right? So therefore we can say that EA sin theta should be equal to EB sin theta, and it implies they would cancel each other. They would cancel each. तो हमारा नेट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड कहां पे लग रहा है? हमारा नेट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इसी डायरेक्शन के अलोंग लग रहा है, राइट? सो वी विल राइट इट डाउन. E इज इक्वल टू EA cos थीटा प्लस EB cos थीटा. दोनों को हमने क्या किया? समअप कर देना है. ठीक है, तो हम क्या लिखेंगे? क्योंकि दोनों के मैग्नीट्यूड आपस में क्या है? बराबर है. तो दैट इज 2 EA cos. So that is 2 k q upon electric field क्या होगा due to point k q upon r square. तो यहाँ पे r की value क्या लिखेंगे? R की value लिखेंगे under root of x square plus a square का whole square into cos theta. तो cos theta की value क्या होगी? Cos theta is equal to what? Base upon hypotenuse. तो base की value क्या है? A. ठीक है, यहाँ पे मैं लिख देता हूँ cos theta is equal to a divided by under root of x square plus a स्क्वायर। अब इसकी वैल्यू यहां पे सब्स्टिट्यूट करो आप x स्क्वायर प्लस a स्क्वायर का अंडर रूट। सो इसका जो एंड रिजल्ट होगा यहां पे इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड, सो e इज इक्वल टू k q इनटू 2a डिवाइडेड बाय x स्क्वायर प्लस a स्क्वायर पावर 3/2। अब देखिए यहां पे सो e इज इक्वल टू k इनटू p, since we know that q into 2a that is equivalent to what, dipole moment, electric dipole moment. So x square plus a square and whole power 3/2, this is your electric field. Ab chahte ho ki value substitute kar dena baat, agar hum mante hain ki x agar bahut bada hai a ke comparison, if it is at a huge means very long distance in comparison to this, okay, it cannot be that long, but only in comparison to this. So we can easily ignore a. तुम्हारे पास equation क्या बनेगा? E is equal to k b divided by x cube. So this is your net electric field. Also be written as p 4 pi epsilon naught x cube. I think this must be very much clear to you all. Just take a look at this, and then we'll proceed further with the third derivation. Fine? Okay? So, now the third thing. Okay? I'll discuss the third part. So, third part is what? It is about electric field at a point. Okay? Now, where is the point? In the first case, the point was on the axial line. In the second case, it was at the equatorial point, and in the third case, it is at any point. Any point. For the students, it is very, very important to take note of this particular point, right? So, see, first, let us draw a diagram. There is a right. That is minus q, and we have plus q. And from the point, we have a point P. Point P at which the electric field is to be determined. Okay. Let it be the position vector r. And it is with inclined at an angle theta with the line joining the dipole. Since the dipole is acting from negative to positive, so it is, we have just mentioned the direction. We will have two components. First of all, we need to resolve it in the form of components. So, since it is P and there has to be two components, so let us assume that this is P1. And let this be P2. Fine. Now, as this is theta, so this particular axis यहाँ पे ऐसे वो क्या होगा sine component होगा, और जो इसका vertical component होगा उस केस में वो क्या होगा cos component होगा. So it will be equal to what, P cos theta, and P2 would be equal to what, P sin theta. Right? Let us assume that E1 electric field is acting along this line and E2 electric field is acting along this line. So the resultant would be somewhere here, E. And let that be inclined at an angle alpha. The resultant and the action of the line of the action of the field. So we know that electric field E, let us talk about E1 is equal to 2 k p upon r. Okay, so we are talking about which one? P1. So substitute it with P1. So we have 2 K. What about P1? P1 is equal to P cos theta. Very much clear? Upon R. Similarly, we have E2. Take it. So E2 is equal to what? That is because it is on the axial line. Take it. So it will be equal to what? Batao aapne? Ye, sir. Ye kya ho gaya aapka? Ye axial line pe ho gaya. Aur ye wala jo equatorial, isme kya tha? Keval K P upon R. तो यहां पे P के जगह पे आप क्या लिखोगे? आप लिखोगे P sin theta. ठीक है? एक्चुअली ये पहले क्या था? P2 था. तो P2 के जगह पे हमने क्या कर दिया इसको? P sin theta. चलो एक स्टेप बढ़ा लेते हैं. P2 and it is equal to K P sin theta upon R. Fine. अब कोई दिक्कत? So, of course, selective form. E is equal to net electric field is equal to E1 vector plus E2 vector. अब इन दोनों वेक्टर में एंगल क्या है? 90. सो अगर मुझे मैग्नीट्यूड निकालना हो, ठीक है, मैग्नीट्यूड अगर निकालना हो तो मैं क्या लिखूंगा? E is equal to under root of E1 square plus E2 square. लिखा जाएगा, ठीक है. I just get rid of this. पता तो है आपको कि पॉइंट कौन सा हम डिस्कस कर रहे हैं, ठीक है. सो E इज इक्वल टू E1 की वैल्यू क्या है? 2 के पी कॉस थीटा अपॉन आर क्यू का होल स्क्वायर प्लस के पी साइन थीटा अपॉन आर क्यू का होल स्क्वायर अंडर फाइन. तो यहां पे क्या रिलेशन बनेगा हमारे पास? सो के पी अपॉन आर क्यू, ये हमारा टर्म बाहर आ जाएगा. बचेगा क्या? अंडर रूट ऑफ 4 कॉस स्क्वायर थीटा प्लस साइन स्क्वायर. तो इसे हम क्या लिख सकते हैं? के पी अपॉन आर क्यू 4 कॉस स्क्वायर थीटा प्लस 1 माइनस कॉस स्क्वायर थीटा. नाउ सी के पी अपॉन आर क्यू, और यहां पे क्या हो गया? 4 माइनस 1 दैट इज 3 कॉस स्क्वायर थीटा प्लस 1. सो दिस इज द रिजल्टेंट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड दैट विल गेट at any point, any discrete point. It is not necessary that it would be what? It would be axial or equatorial. See, ये जो theta है हमारा, axial के case में 0 degree हो जाएगा. So it will be 3. So 3 minus 3 n plus 1 is equal to 4. 4 का under root करोगे तो क्या होगा? 2. ठीक है? तो 2 kp upon r cube. See, वही relation आया. अगर यही मान लो कि थीटा की वैल्यू 90 डिग्री कर लेते इक्वेटोरियल होगा तो थीटा की वैल्यू, ये थीटा क्या होगा? ऐसे है ना पॉइंट सीधा सीधा, तो थीटा की वैल्यू क्या है? 90 डिग्री. तो भाई जब ये 90 डिग्री होगा, ठीक है, तो क्या होगा? 0. तो के भी बना दो. तो एक ये रिलेशन अगर डिटरमाइन करते हैं तो पहले के तो दोनों डेरिवेशन हम लोगों ने किए हैं वो ऑलरेडी आप इसी से ही डिराइव कर सकते हो. देयर इज नो प्रॉब्लम इन दैट. इट इज सिंपल, इज इट? ठीक है, तो चलिए यहां तक देखा हमने. अब क्योंकि वेक्टर के टर्म पे हम लोग इसको रिजॉल्व कर रहे हैं तो वी शुड नो व्हाट एग्जैक्टली इज द रिलेशन बिटवीन, हमने अल्फा बनाया क्यों बनाया भाई? ठीक है, तो वेक्टर जब आपने पढ़ा होगा, ठीक है, तो वेक्टर एक फोर्स इधर काम कर रहा है, एक फोर्स इधर काम कर रहा है, इन दोनों के बीच ये फोर्सेस जो है वो आपके थीटा है. ठीक है, मान राइट इधर मान लिया हमने ए वेक्टर है, इधर बी वेक्टर है, इसका रिजल्टेंट हमारा कुछ इस तरीके से. तो रिजल्टेंट और इसके बीच का जो एंगल अल्फा और थीटा के बीच का एक रिलेशन हमें निकालना होता है हमेशा, राइट? सो कुछ याद आ रहा होगा, राइट? तो यहां पे भी इसका एक रिलेशन फाइंड करेंगे. सो हम क्या लिखते हैं? टैन अल्फा. सो सी दिस इज अल्फा, ठीक है, तो टैन अगर अल्फा लेना है हमें तो परपेंडिकुलर अपॉन बेस लेंगे. सो E2 अपॉन E1. सो E2 अपॉन E1. तो E2 की वैल्यू क्या है? E2 की वैल्यू है आपकी kp साइन थीटा अपॉन आर क्यू, और E1 की वैल्यू क्या है, E1 की वैल्यू आपकी 2kp कॉस थीटा अपॉन आर क्यू। आर क्यूब से ये कैंसल हो गया, k से ये कैंसल हो गया, p से भी कैंसल हो गया, सो अल्टीमेटली यू आर हैविंग 1/2 साइन थीटा अपॉन कॉस थीटा दैट इज इक्वल टू टैन थीटा। तुम्हारे पास फाइनल रिलेशन क्या आया कि टैन अल्फा इज इक्वल टू टैन थीटा अपॉन 2। बाय दिस यू विल गेट द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द रिजल्टेंट, फाइन डायरेक्शन ऑफ द रिजल्ट। सो होप इट मस्ट बी क्लियर टू यू ऑल। सो फॉर टुडे आई थिंक दिस इज प्रिटी वेल एनफ। सो यू गो थ्रू द टॉपिक रिपीटेडली and do give your likes and subscribe the channel and do give your comments so that I can get enough information where I could improve the videos for you. I'll be definitely doing certain numerical problem also, okay? One by one, everything could not be done in a span of 30-20 minutes. So I'm just focusing more on like theoretical part first, and then I'm also inducting several numericals, the critical one also, and we'll be doing separate videos for that also. Well, thank you very much. Have a nice day.